يعطيك العافية عبير، ما قصرتي صراحة، هذا أشياء جدا مهمة في الكلينيكال. قبل لا أوريكم التو سوفتويرز اللي أنا سجلتهم، فيه بعض الارتيفاكت أنا أسميه hidden artifact which is called chemical shift displacement error. So usually this as a thing. So أنت تتوقع أنك تصور الفوكسل هذا، بس في الحقيقة أنت تأخذ السيجنال من فوكسل جنبه بمعدل معين. So the signal out of the voxel are misregistered in the spectrum, and this corresponding range in hertz on bandwidth of RF pulse. يعني الاختلافات بالهرتز تقسيم ال bandwidth of RF pulse يعطيك الريزلت، يعطيك كم عندك chemical shift. فنفترض على 3 تسلا difference between water and lactate. انتم تعرفون مثل ما ورطنا اخذنا عبير، معظم الميتابولايت ما بين اللاكتيت على 1.3 الى الووتر اللي هو 4.7 و 4.65. فعلى 3 تسلا الفرق بينهم اللي 4.7 minus 1.3 it's going to give you 3.4 ppm. So على 3 تسلا 3.4 ppm multiply by 127 and you will get 435 hertz. يعني الفرق في spectral أو على الفريكوانسي من اللاكتيت إلى الووتر it's gonna be 435 hertz. If your bandwidth is only 1000 hertz, يعني نتخيل أنه الـ RF pulse bandwidth عندك 1000 hertz, you will get 44% chemical shift. يعني تقسم 435 على 1000 بيطلع لك، تضربهم في 100 بيطلع لك 44 chemical shift displacement error. يعني هذا الايرور اللي عندك انت، ما انت قاعد تصور، انت قاعد تصور جنب. المشكله انه ممكن تاخذ ريزلت وشكلها كويس وتعتمد عليها، وممكن يو جيت فولس دايجنوستس بسبب هذا. فالحل هو واضح يعني من هنا، انه increase the RF pulse bandwidth and also you have to increase the gradient strength. Because if you increase the bandwidth and maintains the same gradient strength, you will have a larger voxel. يعني لو انت تذكر ال slice thickness, it's the same thing. Slice thickness or voxel size. The bandwidth of RF pulse تقسيم the gradient strength حيطلع لك انت كم عندك slice thickness. كم انت بتصور هال، يعني خلنا نحكي 1 centimeter or 2 or 3. So if we assume that our bandwidth 1000 hertz and our gradient strength 1000 hertz per centimeter, we will get this error. So لنوضح الحل، ممكن نزود الgradient strength. إذا زدنا gradient strength بس فألف تقسيم 2000 اللي هو gradient strength حيقل الكيميكال شيفت، ولكن حيصغر الفوكسل. إذا صغر الفوكسل مثل ما ذكرت عبير حينقص الSNR. وإذا زدنا الاثنين معا، عشان كذا أنا قلت الحل إنه لازم ترفع ال RF pulse bandwidth والgradient. So 2000 over 2000 you will get the same result, but now your chemical shift is 22%. عادة أنت تحاول ترفع ال RF pulse bandwidth as much as possible. إذا عندك أنت press عندك 3 RF pulse ال 90 وال 180 وال 180. مشكلة المشكلة البريس إنه ال 180 بيكون ال RF pulse bandwidth محدود مقارنة بال 90. هذا another advantage للستيم. So and also عادة أنت لو نتذكر ال bandwidth حيتحدد بالوقت حق ال RF pulse. So the limiting factor for your bandwidth is how much power you can carry inside your system in very long time. هذه عادة depends on the type of pulse and the time of pulse and RF pulse power. So قبل أوريكم الفيديو، هذا simulation للسبكترا اللي يمكن أنتم تشوفونها في الهيومن، فتشوف أكثرهم overlapping with each other. يعني مثلا هنا الـ AA الكرياتين overlapped فوق الجابا، الكولين، الجلايسين with minus at all. And here the lipid, and show the lipid of 2, the lactate, فوق او الليبيد فوق اللاكتيت. اختنا عبيد يعني اعطتنا كلينيكال سوليوشن كيف ان احنا نحلها, لكن انا بوريكم الفيزيكس بيهايند ذس بيكوز اللاكتيت وي هاف دبلت يعني دبل بيك, فيكون بينهم السيبريشن بتوين ذم 6.96. This is the J coupling constant. معلومة هذا لا يتغير مع مجال المغناطيسي لأنه يعتمد على روابط الهيدروجين بالكربون في اللاكتيت. فعشان تستخدم التي اي الأفضل, فالقانون يقول إنه التي اي لازم يكون واحد على الجي, الجي كابلينج. الجي كابلينج 6.9 سو واحد تقسيم جي بيعطيك 144 ملي سكند. يعني على 144 ملي سكند you will invert your lactate. If you use 288 يعني دبلت الوقت مرة ثانية, you will invert it back to the positive and then you can do your subtraction to make sure is it lactate or lipids that has abnormal long T2. So this is also, if we see here, so the glycine also overlapped until under the doublet of minocetol. المينوسيتول التو بيك هذه فعليا هي دبلت هنا وهنا دبلت هنا, فالجلايسين maybe 10 time smaller than minocetol, فانت ما تقدر تشوف الجلايسين. ممكن بعض الناس او بعض الاطباء اللي يبغى يشوف الجلايسين, you have to do also again you have to set up your TE where you make the face or the inversion of the doublet of inositol. يعني هنا الانositol على تشوف هنا at TE 20 millisecond, so we can see the glycine doublet becomes away from the glycine. يعني احنا الان هنا ممكن نشوف الجلايسين لان المانوسيتول تغير لان استغلينا الجي ريفولوشن. الان بوريكم مقطعين فيديو, الاول عن ال LCMODEL which is operator independent يعني ما يعتمد على الاوبريتر, fully automatic. انت تقدر تحط الداتا تبعتك وتحللها بشكل سريع. ثم بعد فيديو ثاني عن ال JMRUI, it's free, تقدر تنزل في اللابتوب على لابتوب عادي ويندوز او اي لابتوب مش معك طبعا, فتقدر تشتغل عليه لكنه operator dependent فياخذ وقت. المقطعين كلهم ما يتعدون ممكن 15 دقيقة, فأتمنى أن ما طولنا عليكم. و this is the reference if you are interested. فخلونا نبدأ. أعتذر أن المقطع كان كله بالإنجليش, كنت أحاول أن أحط فيه بعض اللغة العربية لكن يعني سامحونا. Here we are. This is the Linux platform PC. I put my data or example data here in this folder. So you can see there are two folders. So one suppressed signal, one unsuppressed. So I named them myself. And each folder contains the FID. And here is the data set that I got from Steve, who is the developer for LCMODEL. So which is a gamma file press as a sequence, and it matched the same TE that I used, which is 14 millisecond. You can generate your own basis set if you have the sample and solution and everything. So first, just to start with the LCMODEL, you have to call it from the terminal. So here is the terminal. When you open the terminal, you will see that you are in shell console. So you are not an LCMODEL directory, so we have to change the directory and ask for LCMODEL. So change directory to LCMODEL and then slash, and then you can see from here now we are in LCMODEL shell console. So all these codes actually is available in LCMODEL manual. You can find them and then just copy and paste them. So then we have to call LCMGUI. So LCMGUI, and then this is gonna open the program or the software. So here is some profiles that I used to use. So any setting that you like, you can just save it as a profile, and then here you can call it whatever you want. So I'm gonna choose anyone, so just to show you. So here is the instructions. You have, it's very useful to look at it all the time because it's gonna guide you through this process. So it's asked you to select your FID. So we have our FID here, but you have to find it from here. So to go to the desktop from here, and then here is the example, and here is the suppressed signal, and here is the FID. And then after you click on it, you just press OK, and it's gonna open this control panel or the setting. You can choose the analyzing spectrum from 0.2 ppm. Let's change this one to be 4.2. And here is the basis file or the basis set that I showed you before. So it's already selected, but just to show you how, just to find it here, this example and this the file. So gamma, press TE 14, 400 megahertz that I'm using, which is 9.4 Tesla. So press OK, and then you can do eddy current correction, which is recommended. And the water scaling, it's optional. If you don't have unsuppressed signal, so just leave it as is. If you have unsuppressed signal or unsuppressed water, so you can say yes. You wanna do water scaling to give you a very good concentration. And then here is where is the file should be saved. So I don't want to save it here, so I'm gonna delete this one, and then I wanna save it here. So just double click on this and copy, and then paste it here. So our result will be saved here. And then here is advanced setting that you can play with. So here because sometimes I liked, there are so many options actually you can see, but there is one of my favorite options that to simulate about 14 metabolites, and this includes glycine. So if you are looking for glycine, so from here you can say just NSIMURL, so it's like number of simulations equals 14, and this, then press OK on it, and then run LC model. So here's the instructions, will tell you again to select unsuppressed water reference. So here is our example, the folder, and if you double click on it, you will see unsuppressed signal or unsuppressed water. So click on its FID and then OK. And here's, you can, because these things that I have changed, so in symbol equal 14, and these things, you can save it just to give you a consistent result with your study or anything. But for this stage, I'm not gonna save anything, so don't save change. And then this will tell us, and if you see the terminal, will tell you, yeah, now it took like 8 seconds. So here is the result. If you double click in it, maximize it, and then go to view, seascape, where is it? Yep, here. Yeah, here is your result. So the black line, or it looks like the noise one, this is your actual data, and the red line is the fitting data. So it looks, the fitting is very good here, so this result is good. So we can see from 0.2 to 4.2, and here is the list of your metabolite. So this is the advantage of LC model, that's it. So it's very very quick. So you can see your GABA, your glutamine, glutamate, your iron acetol, lactate, NAA, and glycine. If we didn't put in simule equals 4, we will not get a glycine. So we have here glycine, our choline, total NAA, and all other stuff. And also here we can see, you can see it, I'm not sure if you can see it or not. So the full width at half maximum, which is 0.054 ppm, which equals like maybe 20 hertz, 21 hertz, which is a good shimming. On the next page, if you go, yeah, here's the next page. You can see if you have any errors, if your data is very good, it's gonna come here. And also all your settings. So here is in simule equal for 14. So you know from the file what have you input, which is good. That's it, and thank you very much. Here we are.
Sorry.
Okay. Now I'm gonna show you how can we process and analyze spectroscopy using JMRUI. So from here we have just to go to this shortcut that I've made and then double click on it, and then the software will open. So we have to click on this one when the time series. So we have here a few data. So you can see this RDA, which is Simmons data. So this is the result without any pre-processing. As you can see, it needs some phase correction, and it needs the line width to be a little bit broader by choosing or by multiplying exponential function to our FID, which means that the FID will become shorter. So it's like a shorter T2O star will result in a broader peak. So but this is going to smooth out our spectrum. So from here, pre-processing, apodize, and then we can choose any number, let's say 5, and you can see the result now becomes smooth, but still need it needs phase correction. So we have to we have to press in hard phase and press all, and then we have two options: zero phase correction and the first phase correction. So if we play with this one, we have to watch for our NAA and ignore water. So once we're happy, we can also change the first order phase correction. It is a little bit sensitive, but we can set it up. And if we are happy, we can just click on hard phase, and this is gonna save it for us. Then let's maximize this one. We can see here NAA is not in the right frequency, because we know NAA has 2 ppm. So double click on this one and then set reference. We can say, so then here press 2. Now it is in right position and all other peaks in the same way. Now we can start our quantification process. So we can click in quantification and choose Ameris, and then this open, and we have to set our peaks manually. So this is our lactate. We have just click on it, and then another click to determine the line width, as you can see here. And then we have to go to all peaks. So then NAA. So I'm gonna pause the video here to make it short and useful. So once we are done, as you can see, we choose five peaks, but we have to name them. So this one is going to be lactate, and we have to go the same for all the other metabolites. So then we have to go to prior knowledge. Here is everything estimated. So the amplitude. So from prior knowledge, there are some things that is fixed already. For example, the relative phase. So we have to click on each metabolite and choose fix. So then we can go to the line width for all these metabolites. So we have to press in soft constraint. We can choose any number that we think that fits the best with our data. So let's say from 2 to 50 hertz for lactate, and let's fill all other peaks. So once we finished from the line width, we have now to set up the range, the frequency range. So first, let's start with lactate. So soft constraint, because we know lactate has 1.3 ppm. So let's say the range is going to be from 1, maybe 0.2 to 1.4. So we have to be careful for this range to not overlap with other metabolites. So after we finish from setting up our range, so we have just to save it. So from here, go to database again, and then save as, let's call it again, test 2. So now we have to go to overall phase. So the phase as we fix it, so we have to change it to be fixed. And then the weighting, we can switch it on or off. So once we finished this, we have to press in quantification or quantify. And this is our result. So we can maximize the window. So here is the original data. And here is the estimated. And here is the residual. If you have no residual, means your processing is good. Here is our table. Here is our result. This is the amplitude that we can rely on. And next to it, the standard deviation. This is the line width for each metabolite. So that's it. I hope. Okay. يعطيكم العافية. أتمنى أن المقطعين هذول في السوفت وير كانوا مفيدين، وأتمنى أني أنا وعبير قدمنا الشيء اللي تطمحون له. Please, if you have any question, just